Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is an outdoor access point, part of the TP-Link Omada range. This is the EAP610-Outdoor. It's an AX1800, so it's a wireless 6 access point that probably does around about 500 megasecond in the 2.4 gigahertz range and around about 1.2 gigahertz, gigabits a second in the 5 gigahertz range. Does have a 1 gig Ethernet card, so that is its limiting factor. Right, quite a lot of bits to show you in the box. So you're going to get a little guide there to all the other components that make up Omada, which is switches, other access points, routers, and so forth. You're just going to get a software license document. You're going to get your little warranty. We're in Australia, so that's a relevant one for Australia. And you're going to get your quick installation guide. So this is just going to show you basically how it all plugs together. It is a PoE powered device with PoE in the box. Then what else are we going to get? We're going to get a number of packets of screws and lugs, depending on how you are going to mount that. You are going to get a seal for putting your Ethernet cable into the device, because this is outdoor and rated for outdoor. You are going to get a bracket to be able to mount this on a wall, which I'll show you in a moment. You're going to get your zip ties to be able to zip tie this directly to a pole or a post. You are going to get a short Ethernet cable, maybe half a meter. We're here in Australia, so there's your mains on that side. And you've got your Mickey Mouse or cloverleaf connector on that side. You are going to get your PoE injector. I wouldn't mount this outside. It's not designed to be mounted outside. You can mount it on the wall. There is a bracket that comes with it here, so we can mount this on the wall. Remember that this can be up to 100 meters away from the access point itself. So put this on the inside or somewhere undercover and then run an Ethernet cable to the device itself. So this is the device. Let's have a little look at the back first. Here we have, hopefully you can see the back mounting, and you can see it's got the ribs on here. This is for mounting against a post. If we've got our post or pole, then we're going to pass our zip ties through the back there, and that will allow us to zip tie it directly. If we're wanting to mount this on our main, on a wall, then we can use our fixing plate, which is this one here. We can fix this directly to the wall, and then we can bring this down into place and clip it into place to hold that in position. So what else do we have on the device? What you're mainly really interested in, what's on the bottom. So we have our earthing spike here, and then we have our Ethernet in. So obviously our power and data are going to be mixed back somewhere where it's waterproof and near a power socket. We're going to run our Ethernet cable out to here. We're going to run it through our grommet and seal, which will fit onto the bottom here. And obviously that will then give it a full waterproof seal. All I would say, if you are going to mount this, I probably would have a drip loop. So again, you're going to come out with the cable out the wall here, and you're going to come down below it and then feed up into it. It means any of the moisture that gathers here on the cable will drop down and off the bottom and not want to ingress into the device itself. So a really great, versatile, waterproof device, outdoor wireless 6 access point. That is the TP-Link Omada EAP610-Outdoor. Head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more box openings on wireless network and firewall devices. What do I need to run TP-Link Omada? Some of the reviews on the other access points as well. So subscribe and stay up to date.